here's our eggs, here's our milt. So in order to get these eggs fertilized, what we have to do is we have to replicate what happens in the river. Now, mom in the river uses her caudal fin and her tail, and she digs down usually 30, 45 centimeters. She can even go that deep in the rocks, and she digs a little rat. And then she puts between 500 and 800 eggs in there usually. Dad swims over those eggs, puts milk on those eggs, mom comes back and covers them up. So we'll look at that a little bit more carefully. Right now, there's our eggs, and what I'm gonna do is now I'm going to activate the milt. Outside, I tried to make sure that I didn't mix water with the milt, because once water gets mixed in here, it's activated, and then we've got less, you know, we've got seconds basically before this is not working anymore. So let's activate the milt. Let's add this to the eggs. Let's get these eggs fertilized. Each of those eggs should have a small little hole called an ovule. The milt goes in there, those eggs get fertilized. In the river, when the milt comes out of the male's body, it goes on those eggs that are in that little nest. And then once that milt touches those eggs are fertilized, the milt comes up and the current has carried that milt away. Here, those eggs are fertilized. We don't need the milt anymore. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna pour that milt off. We could, in the river again, this just flows away. So if you pour it off, then it's better than adding it to your aquarium. We want to try to keep your aquarium as clean as we possibly can. I'm going to clean this off a little bit better. The temperature of the tank water is very similar to the temperature that it was outside. So that's something we have to be careful that we don't make the water different temperatures, or else it'll shock the eggs. Pretty good. Yeah, that's good. Okay, so now let's add them into their new home. I'm going to allow Alex to do that, seeing he's going to be the off of here. And what we do is we just kind of sprinkle them and spread them out. Now, we spread them out in the school aquariums and out here, but in the river, mom puts them all together and she has them touching. We would prefer them not to touch, because if there's an egg or two that didn't get fertilized, it's going to end up going rotten. And if it's touching another egg that is starting to have a little embryo grow, then it could spread that on to the good egg and it could kill that egg too.
Are we trying to bury them all with two?
No, we don't bother in the school. Yeah, here. Mom buries them though, and she buries them to make sure that the predators don't eat them. We don't have to worry about that here. She buries them to make sure that the current doesn't carry them away. Well, we don't have to worry about that here. And mom also buries them to keep the light off of them. Sunlight will kill the eggs. In the aquarium setting, the lights that are above you will kill those eggs. So we have got this cover that we are going to be putting on the aquariums, and this is going to stay there until they become fry. So just to look at the aquarium, we have to make sure that they've got everything that they need in here that they would have in the river. In the river, they've got cold water. This little metal rectangular bar at the back, that's your fridge bar, and that's what keeps the water cold. Right now, the temperature is 5 degrees Celsius. So that's a nice cold temperature, and that's similar to what was outside. They also need oxygen. Outside, we have the oxygen bubbler, and in the over here, in this corner of the tank, you can see the little bubbles coming out of there. So cold water, oxygen, darkness, and the last thing that these eggs need right now is they need no bumping or moving. So when mom covers them up with 30 or so centimeters of rocks, that's also to protect them, so that if something does go through the creek or the river, it's not going to be basically stepping on top of those and killing the little embryos.